Shalom Malkiam, peace and blessings to the hopeful elect, laboring in this word, in truth, and sincerity. Just want to come back with a lesson here. The name of this lesson is going to be Lord's Vengeance. You know, just something that felt on the spirit. You know, dealing with, all these people out here that are pushing, doing this work, doing wickedness, and helping Esau push his wicked NWO and coming after the Lord's children and those that are trying to uphold righteousness. So before I start, I'd like to give all praises unto Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Raka Kodash. Yahweh being the true name of the Heavenly Father, and Yahweh Shai being the true name of the only begotten Son. And double honors to the elders and the head apostles of Great Millstone who rule well and teach well. And shalom to the hopeful elect laboring in this truth. You know, you so-called Native Americans, Negroes, and Latinos, you are the true tribes of Israel and those scattered abroad. Shalom, peace and blessings unto you. May you hold firm, stand firm in this truth, and endure until the end. So I just want to, you know, start with a little backstory of, what got me in the spirit to do this lesson. At work, it's dealing with a couple testing centers on site at my job, and we have a third party company called Fulgent that comes here and out here in California that does the testing, and they're hiring a couple of more people to work at the testing center, and kind of mentioned to them that that those testing centers are always empty. There's nobody going there, it's dead over there. And, this older man from the tribe of Judah, he mentioned he was a new employee working in there. And he mentioned that there's going to be some new government mandates coming down and going to be coming down in early November, in the next 7 to 9 days. So, mentioned that, of course, these unrighteous decrees, are going to continue happening no matter what the numbers, the statistics are, whatever it is, Esau's agenda. And we've got these wicked Jakes out there working for Esau, pushing this and just to get a paycheck, just blinded to the truth. So let him know that, of course, these unrighteous decrees are happening, and he really needs to take heed and look into the scriptures. But, of course, dude's probably, juiced up. He's blind. He's one of them two-thirds. And jump into the scriptures here. Made me think of Isaiah 10 and 1 reads, "Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees, and that right grievousness which they have prescribed." So yeah, they're out here prescribing this juice, right? The beetle juice, saying this is gonna be the cure, and people think that this is a cure, and that once they take this thing, that they're safe, and that they can have their life back. But we know that that's not true. We know that they're going to continue pushing that end goal further and further, keeping Jake on a string, keeping all these heathen people, everybody on a string, until they finally bring you to that MOTB, the Kerygma, the digital all, where that's really going to be the cure-all, they say. It's already been released. A lot of the brothers know DARPA. Been involved in working on that and developing it, and that's going to be the cure-all for all Crown Vicky. And that's supposed to, you know, be the false miracles that Esau has the world fooled with, but the elect will not be deceived. And decree, you know, woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees, which are these mandates that you're unable to work, you're unable to rent a home here, or you're unable to go eat here, do this or that, and it's gonna get heavier and heavier as this thing goes on. And decrees means statutes, action prescribed, because they want you to have to take that action that they're telling you to do. They're giving you an order, and you don't follow through with that order, and you're gonna be outcast. And we know that we're outcasted in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. And that's that's in a way, that's a beautiful thing for us to know that we're being outcasted and persecuted for the name of Yahweh Shai, standing firm. So continue here, Isaiah 10 and 2 reads, to turn aside the needy from judgment, and to take away the right from the poor of my people, that widows may be their prey, and that they may rob the fatherless. And what will ye do in the day of visitation, and in the desolation which come from far? To whom will ye flee for help, and where will ye leave your glory? So yeah, all these people, the two-thirds of Jake, that want to turn to these false idols, false gods, worshiping Allah and Buddha and all these, Jesus Cristo, everything, man, they're not going to be put under that protection. They're not going to be given this light and this truth during these times. And Esau's preying on these people because they have been separated from the power of Yahweh. And so, what will they do in the day of visitation? Who will stand in that day of desolation when Yahweh, Bashem Yahushai, comes down with his vengeance and his wrath? Who's going to be able to stand in that day? That's the elect, the 144,000 that have been woken up in this time to not be fooled by Esau's agenda, his NWO, to see the prophecy. The prophets, the 144,000, are going to stand firm. Those that are giving this warning right now and preaching this word. So what will the rest do in this day of visitation? They won't be able to stand. They're not going to have anywhere to flee for help. They won't have any name to call upon. They don't have the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. And therefore, their glory is going to be gone away with. All the things that they're proud, they glorify themselves with in this flesh here, in this mortal body, this weak carnal body, they have all their treasures laid up here. They're, roughly paraphrasing, they're moth-eaten, they're robbed from Esau. All of it's going to be for naught. Everything that they've worked their whole lives for and built up and they're so proud of, it's going to be gone in just a second. And then they're not going to have anything to stand on because they don't have the faith and they don't have this truth. They've been left blind. And they don't seek it. I'm going to jump over to Job 40 and 7. And this is the Lord, speaking to Job, a faithful servant of Yahweh. And he's telling him, gird up thy loins now like a man. I will demand of thee and declare thou unto me. So that's what the elect are having to do during these times. Girding up our loins. We're putting on our, that same mentality that Yahweh Shai had, a very stern, very stoic. We're preparing ourselves for what's to come. You know, we know that we can't be overly emotional. We can't be too invested. We have to be seeking our own salvation with fear and trembling. So we have to prepare our mind and cast away the mortal thoughts that are heaviest unto us, because we know we're going to see, you know, days of evil ahead. And we know that it's very vexing that the two-thirds aren't taking heed to this word. And a lot of our loved ones are not turning to this word and to this light. But we have to gird up our loins like a man, and you know, we have to walk this walk alone. This is a straight, narrow path that many will not seek to walk or attempt to. It says, "Will thou also annul my judgment? Will thou condemn me that thou mayest be righteous? Hast thou an arm like Yahweh, or canst thou thunder with a voice like him? Deck thyself now with majesty and excellency, and array thyself with glory and beauty." So yeah, he's saying, who has the power like Yahweh? That's the almighty power, the living power. There's none that can do the works of Yahweh. There's no other salvation except in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You can't save yourself. The Lord can take you out any second. That's why you have to be thankful for every day you have. It says, "Cast abroad the rage of thy wrath, and behold, everyone that is proud, and abase him. Look on everyone that is proud, and bring him low, and tread down the wicked in their place." So yeah, we have to be trying to rebuke these demons, man. These two-thirds out here that have been given that covenant, you know, our lineage going back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You know, they have a promise with the Lord, you know, to be a holy people, separate from the entire world. But yet they want to follow the heathen, and they want to be wicked ass demons. They're proud. They have pleasure in doing wickedness and going against the Most High. They don't want to repent. We have to rebuke those demons. And everyone that is proud is going to be brought low. So that abase him. We have to abase them. Abase meaning to bring low, to humble, to put low, to humiliate. And we're going to do that with the word of the Lord, right? That's what we do out here when we're preaching, when we're out there on the highways and hedges preaching this good word. Because this word cuts like a sword. It is a double-edged sword unto the wicked, man. Cuts them up. That's why they walk around the brothers preaching out there, man. They don't want to dare step to the brothers. They want to cross the street. They want to avoid the word as much as they can. So we look upon everyone that is proud and seek to bring him low. We know that the Lord is going to do that. He's going to tread down the wicked in their place. It's through the sword, through the famine, pestilence, and ultimately in the day of the Lord's visitation, where Babylon is going to be destroyed in 1 hour. We have to be seeking to be part of that election. By doing this work for him, by preaching this word, by keeping the faith and repenting. It says Isaiah, or Salakia, this is Psalms 37, I'll start at 9, and it reads, "For evildoers shall be cut off, But those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. So all those wicked ass people, the heathen and those 2/3, are going to be cut off, meaning killed, destroyed, burnt up in that visitation, man. You know, if they even make it to that day. You know, we're going to see a lot of people, you know, a lot of people dying before that even gets to that day of the Lord's visitation. But those that wait upon the Lord, the elect, those that have stood firm for the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahu Shai, they shall inherit the earth, the kingdom. You know, we know that Esau is the end of the world and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. Jacob, meaning the elect, the 144,000. You know, our forefather Jacob, Israel, prince of the power. We are princes of the power. You know, if your seed goes back to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. It says, for yet a little while, and the wicked shall not be. So yeah, we have to wait. We have to wait patiently. Even though we're vexed in this wicked ass place, we have to pray to endure to the end. And the wicked shall not be. Thou shalt diligently consider his place, and it shall not be. Yeah, we're going to be thinking about, oh shit, these people are dropping everywhere. This place is through, it's being destroyed. And you're going to be like, wow, they aren't even here anymore. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai really did his number. He followed through with vengeance. He is going to avenge his elect. Because the Lord said, vengeance is mine. And when we consider them, going to be like they never even existed. It says, but the meek shall inherit the earth and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. So yeah, we're finally going to have our land of rest. Things of righteousness is finally going to bear fruit again. It's going to be profitable. All our good works are going to be rewarded. We're going to have delight and peace. Because we're going to be able to finally keep the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High, which have been to keep us in peace and love and of a sound mind, man, and healthy and strong. And yeah, it's going to be beautiful, man. That kingdom it's going to be beautiful. The kingdom here on earth is going to be gonna be judges, kings, gonna definitely have our lot there, you know. And the elect are gonna receive those crowns from Yahweh Shai. It's gonna be a beautiful thing. So that's something we have to hope for, and we have to pray on, that we are part of that number. It says, Psalms 37:12, the wicked plotteth against the just and gnasheth upon him with his teeth. So yeah, Esau is like a roaring lion, you know, seeking to devour who he can. Those that don't have this truth, those that are simple-minded. The simple-minded will not go unpunished. Esau, the wicked, is plotting against the just. You know, Esau is the most vile person there ever was, man. And he's plotting against the just, those that walk uprightly in this truth. You know, he's coming after Yasharallah and the 12 tribes. You know, but he's not able to to touch the elect, because the Lord has placed he's placing a cover, a shield over the elect. You know, we got that armor of the Lord on, and we know that if we continue to just have faith in that, faith in the Lord and trust the Lord, that we will be, you know, he will take control, and whatever we go through, that he will provide, and he'll put us where we need to be. You know, and if some of us have to be martyrs for this truth, so be it. We know that they'll be raised, the dead will be raised up first, that died in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, right before the elect get pulled up, before the destruction of Babylon. It says, the Lord shall laugh at him, for he seeth that his day is coming. So he's going to laugh at these wicked ass people, Esau, the heathen, and even these two-thirds. He's going to laugh at them and their calamity. You know, he saved himself the last laugh, you know. For he knows the day of his destruction is coming, and they aren't going to have anywhere to run to, nowhere to hide. It says, the wicked have drawn out the sword and have bent their bow to cast down the poor and needy and to slay such as be of upright conversation. So yeah, Esau with these mandates and his military, his weapons, you know, out there in every different country trying to flex their power, trying to force their views and their Western philosophy on the whole world. And out here in Babylon, with these mandates, man, they're casting them down on the poor and the needy, because he knows that Jake, especially, you know, Jake is living month to month, man. They don't have nothing to fall back on. They need their jobs. They need this. They need to be able to provide for themselves. That's what they say, because they don't have faith in the Lord, or they only see the day to day, and they think that they have to take this thing to survive. They seek to save it their life, but they shall surely lose it by following Esau and his wicked devices, man. And of course, Esau is going to draw out the sword, his military. He's going to flex them out on the streets. He's going to shut down certain states, governments and police forces and things like that, and he's gonna send his military out there, and he might possibly send out, you know, the UN as well, because these military, you know, people are, you know, they aren't with it neither. They aren't with the hokey pokey, and they're being you know, dishonorably discharged and threatened to lose their benefits or their retirements and things like that, you know. And that's part of Esau's unrighteous decrees, man. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. That's for all you wicked ass Jakes that are out there working for Esau, pushing his mandates. It says, their sword shall enter into their own heart, and their bows shall be broken. So yeah, they want to go at you. They want to, you know, live by the sword, die by the sword, man. They want to go out there and take that juice, save themselves, try to continue Babylon, or try to trust Esau. It's going to be their own demise. It's going to enter into their own heart. And it's going to kill them, man. It's going to destroy them. There's no salvation for them. You know, and their bows shall be broken, because they're not going to have any power, man. This is a little that a righteous man hath is better than the riches of many wicked. So yeah, that faith that the righteous have, you know, doing the works of the Lord, is much better than the riches of many wicked, because none of those riches are going to save you. especially when that sedition's here. It don't matter what you got. People are going to be out there running wild, man. Running wild, breaking into places, home invasions, looting businesses, man. They're going to be out there robbing, shooting, killing. And who they going to go after, man? They're going to go after people with riches, material riches of this carnal world. You're going to be a target. If you've placed all your values on those things, you know, all your treasures in that, they're going to go after those. Those people are the target, man. It says, for the arms of the wicked shall be broken, but the Lord upholdeth the righteous. So yeah, the wicked are going to be brought low. Going to be left with no power, no nothing, man. Because they didn't keep the laws of the Most High, man. They don't praise and glorify Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. The Lord doesn't know them, man. But the Lord is going to uphold the righteous, his elect. And the Lord knoweth the days of the upright, and their inheritance shall be forever. So they're going to have that glory. They're going to inherit the kingdom, which is being prepared for the elect. And the Lord knoweth the days of the upright, man. That's why he's shortening the days for the elect's sake. It says, they shall not be ashamed in the evil time, and in the days of famine they shall be satisfied. So yeah, the elect have the faith, man. They trust in the Most High. Therefore, they're going to be satisfied. The Lord's going to provide, man. We can't have no doubts, no worries. We just got to have faith in the Lord. It says, we shall not be ashamed in the evil time. Jacob's trouble. When great shame is going to come upon those that trusted in Esau. That are going to see that devil for who he really is. And it says, but the wicked shall perish. And the enemies of the Lord shall be as the fat of lambs. They shall consume into smoke. Shall they consume away. So yeah, they're going to be like those burnt offerings of old. Going to burn in the fire of the Lord's indignation. The missiles. Going to be missile food. When the chariots come with destruction, man. They're going to be burnt up. The wicked are all going to be burnt up, man. Those are enemies of the Lord. Why we have to remember, friendship with the world is enmity with the Most High. So those who aren't walking uprightly, upholding the laws, statutes, and commandments to the best of their ability, repenting in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushua, we can't be associating with them like that, man. We can't have pity on people that are doing wickedness. Jump over to Proverbs 1 and 24. This reads, because I have called and ye refused, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded, but ye have set at naught all my counsel and would none at my reproof. So yeah, they don't listen to the counsel of the Most High, the correction. They would none of it, none of my reproof. They don't want to be corrected. They don't want to give up the things that aren't of the Lord's, man. Those things that go against the word, those things that are carnal of the flesh, man, that are vanity, that are going off, man. They don't want to give those things up. They don't want to give up eating abominable foods. They don't want to follow and give up their give up the pagan holidays, man, and follow the you know, the high holy days. You know, Jake don't want to stop edging his freaking, giving himself lineups, man, and tattoos and all this wicked ass shit, man. Jake don't want to give it up. And the Lord has given his elect, his prophets, out here to correct, out here to give counsel. But Jake don't want to give up that lifestyle, man. Jake continually want to go off, man. He want to get lit, man. He all about that party life and YOLO. But those are the ways of death, man. Those are the ways that Esau laid and set upon you for you to fall into, man, and to try to kill you off without him having to lift a finger. The Lord says right here, Proverbs 1:26, I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. Yeah, it's going to be a great fearful day when the Lord's vengeance comes down, man. You know, all the mighty men are going to be brought low and they're going to be travailing like a woman in labor. They're going to be hiding, man. They're going to be out here looking soft, man. It says, when your fear cometh as desolation and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you. It says, they shall call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. Because the Lord don't know you. You want to come trying to seek the Lord, even in the day when it's really bad, when you're scared, when you need the Lord to save you because you don't have any way to protect yourself, and you see all hell breaking loose, you're going to call upon the Lord, but he ain't going to answer. You're going to seek him in your affliction. When things start really getting bad, then you're going to seek him early, but you're not going to find him. You're not going to have the prophets to run to near. We have to be seeking our own salvation. And we're giving you the warning before this thing happens, man. But you don't want to listen. It says right here, for they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They would none of my counsel. They despised all my reproof. Therefore shall they eat the fruit of their own way and be filled with their own devices. So yeah, they trust in this world, man. They trust in science. They trust in Esau. They trust in Buddha, Allah, all this other shit, man. They don't trust in Yahweh Bashem Yahushai and keeping true to the word, man. To the scriptures. They don't want to hear it, man. They don't want none of it. They don't want to listen to you if you're talking that. They don't want, as soon as you start talking about the word, man, then they don't want to hear none of it, man. They want to leave the room. They want to change the topic, man. It's like, yeah, it cuts them deep, man. And they know that they're wicked. That's why. And they got those demons on them, man. Yeah, and then this is, these are those that scoff and mock, man. They want to laugh at the Lord. They want to laugh at the prophets. Think that we're just crazy and that we're bums and that we're just mad. But they don't see that this is the most precious gift of all, man. This is salvation. They don't care about their salvation, man. But they are. When all hell breaks loose, man, they're going to realize that the men of the Lord are, they're not to be mocked. They're not to be messed with. They're going to seek them. just like they're going to seek to call on the Lord to save them, but the Lord is not going to answer. The Lord is going to laugh at their calamity and mock them for mocking the Lord, man, and his word and his prophets that he sent. Just to back that up, brought up Jeremiah 35 and 15. I have sent also unto you all my servants, the prophets, rising up early and sending them, saying, return ye now every man from his evil way and amend your doings, and go not after other gods to serve them, and ye shall dwell in the land which I have given to you and to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the covenant. You know, prophets rising up early before this destruction, man, warning you, being the watchman, saying to you, repent, return now unto the Lord from your evil ways and change your doings, amend your doings. But no, they don't want to listen. It says right here, but ye have not inclined your ear nor hearkened unto me. So yeah, they don't want to listen. So they're gonna have to pay the bill. It's Isaiah 10 and 20, and it reads, and it shall come to pass in that day that the remnant of Israel, Yasharala, and such as are escaped of the house of Jacob. So that's talking about the remnant, the elect, the 144,000, the prophets, those repenting in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. So they're going to escape this destruction of Babylon. It says, and such as are escaped of the house of Jacob shall no more again stay upon him that smote him, but shall stay upon the Lord, the Holy One of Israel, in truth. That's right. So no more going to be in captivity, man, under Esau. Going to be inherit the kingdom, man. We're going to be staying upon Yahweh Shai and Yahweh, man. This kingdom on earth here, the new Jerusalem. It says, the remnant shall return, even the remnant of Jacob, unto the mighty power. For though thy people Israel be as the sand of the sea, so scattered abroad, all four corners, shalom to the brothers, yet a remnant of them shall return. So yeah, 144,000 scattered everywhere, man. They're gonna return unto the kingdom in that day. And the consumption decreed shall overflow with righteousness. So yeah, you know, the elect are coming back to that righteousness, man, by the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah, Bashem Rakah Kodash. You know, they've been given the spirit of truth, and they're waking up through the elders and head apostles, man, on down. It says, for the Lord Yahweh of hosts shall make a consumption even determined in the midst of all the land. So yeah, the Lord's choosing his servants and separating the sheep from the goat, man. I'm gonna jump over to Malachi 4. It's talking about the day of the Lord. It says, for behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. So yeah, when Yahweh Shai returns with those chariots of fire, and when the nukes are hitting Babylon, man, America here, it's getting burned as an oven. And all the proud, yet ye and all that do wickedly shall be stubble. So they're going to be chaff, man. They're going to be stubble. They're going to be dead bones, man. Dried up. I mean, they already are dead, but yeah, they're going to be corpses out here, man. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch. Yeah, the wicked are going to be cut off completely. It says, but unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and ye shall go forth and grow up as calves of the stall. Yeah, because Yahushua is coming to pluck his elect, to bring them up in them chariots, to beam them up, man. You know, he's going to protect them. And the elect are going to, they're going to grow in the spirit, man. They're going to be given celestial bodies and celestial powers, a new name, and they're going to grow up in the, you know, in righteousness. They're going to be taught in their inward parts, man. They're going to be given a new name. Just like, you know, going to be in the twinkling of an eye, like it says in 1 Corinthians 15. You know, going to be given perfect bodies and knowing, keeping all the laws, statutes, and commandments. Be given celestial power, man. And ye shall tread down the wicked, for they shall be ashes under the soles of your feet in the day that I shall do this, said the Lord of hosts. So, yeah. Gonna be ashes under the soles of your feet in that day. It's gonna be a lot of destruction, ash after the fire, you know. Gonna be a lot of ash of bones and bodies, man, that are burnt up. Gonna tread down the wicked, you know, any of those that are hiding in them bunkers, this or that, and be rooted up and destroyed. You're gonna dig them out of the depths of hell where they're hiding. It says, remember ye the law of Moses, my servant, which I commanded unto him in Horeb for all Israel, which the statutes and commandments. Yeah, gonna have the laws in our inward parts, man. All the statutes and commandments we're going to be able to finally keep again. It says, behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. So yeah, that has to happen before the day of the Lord, right? And Elijah the prophet, you know, through the elders, we have learned that Elijah the prophet, we believe, reincarnated first as John the Baptist. You know, Elias meaning, you know, Elias, Elijah. You know, those two names are often put together. You know, Elijah is Elias. And it says, we believe that, you know, that Elijah the prophet was reincarnated first as John the Baptist 2,000 years ago, you know. John the Baptist, he was preparing, you know, the birth, you know, baptizing Israelites, you know, when we knew we were Israelites back then, you know, he was preparing the birth of Yahusha. And then, you know, the elders, you know, taught us that we believe, you know, that he came back the second time and reincarnated as Abba Bivens, who brought out this truth to wake up and raise up the dry bones of Israel, you know, as referenced in Ezekiel 37. You know, he woke up the elect to this truth, man. You know, he taught, you know, the elder apostles, which taught us, man. So it's a beautiful thing. That's why we give double honors to the elders and head apostles. You know, may they have glory for that, man. And that had to happen, you know. We had to wake up to who we are again. Wake up to our heritage and repent. You know, the Lord had to do that to raise up his elect and wake them up before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord, before the return of Yahushua. And he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children, and the heart of the children to their fathers, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse. So yeah, Abba Bivens had to wake up us to this truth, man. You know, the elder apostles on down, we had to be given this truth, man. We had to turn back to our fathers, you know, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and remember our heritage. And the heart of the children, you know, the children being us, man, being the Israelites, the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So we had to come back to our heritage and remember who we are, because, you know, Esau has destroyed our heritage. He pulled us away from this truth. He did his number, man, trying to get rid of this truth and trying to, you know, make the whole world think that the Amalekites are the Israelites, man. But we know that that's false, man. It's a lie. And through the blessing of the Holy Spirit, we have woken up to this truth, man. And we have the elders and head apostles to thank for waking us up and for being diligent in this work, in the ministry. That had to happen before Yahushua come and smite the earth with a curse, with his destruction, man. You know, lest means for fear that, you know. So we fear that, not being part of that elect, man. That's why we do this work. That's why we're praying and hoping to be of the elect. And it says, and, you know, smite the earth with a curse. A curse being a thing devoted, man. To ban, a net appointed to utter destruction. So yeah, this is a promise. The Lord saying, yeah, I'm devoted. I am gonna come back and smite the earth. I'm gonna punish them. I'm gonna come with destruction to Babylon, man. So that's a fearful thing. If you're not part of that elect, you're gonna be destroyed. And the earth is gonna, you know, Babylon, it's gonna be destroyed, man. The kingdom is going to be established where the elect under Yahushua are going to rule, man, in righteousness. So that's a fearful thing, to not be part of that elect. That's why if you hear this word, you have to repent and do your best to use this time that you have now to ask for forgiveness and do the best you can to serve the Lord and to keep his ways. This is going to be a reading from Zechariah 14:12, and it reads, "And this shall be the plague wherewith the Lord will smite all the people that have fought against Jerusalem." So against the elect, man, against Israel. It says, "Their flesh shall consume away while they stand upon their feet, and their eyes shall consume away in their holes, and their tongues shall consume away in their mouth." You're gonna be burnt up, man, through and through. The Lord's gonna turn on that oven, man, and he's gonna forget to turn it off, man. You're going to put it on all the way high and let that thing cook all the way through. You're just getting people's flesh, and the nukes are going to burn away right where they stand, man. Eyes, all of it, man. The tongues, right where they stand. Their eyes are going to consume away in their holes. Their tongue consume away in their mouth. They're going to be cooked, instantly fried. And it shall come to pass in that day that a great tumult from the Lord shall be among them. So tumult, meaning destruction, trouble, confusion, turmoil, panic, vexation. So yeah, you're gonna, this world's gonna be panicking when them nukes are coming, man. When they hear the sirens going off, man. Emergency broadcasts, blurting on your radios, your TVs, man. You ain't gonna have nowhere to run, man. It's gonna be instant, and even before that, there's just gonna be days of evil, confusion, turmoil, man. It's gonna be all hell breaking loose. And they shall lay hold everyone on the hand of his neighbor. So they're gonna be severe out here, man. People are gonna be growing rigid. You know, that's what this means, man. Grievous, you know. People are gonna be invading another for the lack of goods, like the scripture says, man. Out there spoiling his neighbor, robbing him, killing him for a damn can of beans, man. You know, women are gonna be preyed upon. Those that are, you know, don't have protection from a man of the Lord, those that are single and proud, you know, it's gonna be a great fearful day. And we're gonna again realize, like the scriptures say, is a man is a cover from the tempest, you know, from the winds, from that day of chaos, man. A man of the Lord is gonna be, it's gonna be a strength, man. It's gonna be a shield. Elect man. And they shall hold every one on the hand of his neighbor, and his hand shall rise up against the hand of his neighbor. So yeah, they're gonna use whatever power, whatever strength they have. They're gonna prey on the weak. You know, it's gonna be dog eat dog out there, man. You can use whatever weapons, guns they have, just whatever. Whatever they got, they're going to come after you with it, man, and try to take what they can. So that's going to be a very, very dog-eat-dog world out there, man. You know, Jake already knows, you know, those rough neighborhoods, what that's all about, man. But that's going to be intensified, man, on just a whole nother level, man. It's going to be like a nightmare, man. Like, it's gonna be like the purge, man. This is Luke 18. I'll start at 7 here, and it reads, "And shall not Yahweh avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them?" Yeah, we have to wait. We have to be patient, man, for that salvation. We have to pray to endure till the end, man. But we know that Yahweh is going to avenge his elect, man. He's going to revenge them. He's going to punish the wicked, man. Because, you know, we're bearing right now. We're trying to endure till the end, man. Doing as best as we can to please the Lord. We're crying day and night unto him. We're praying. We're prophesying out there. We're rebuking these demons in this wicked world, man. And we're trying to do our best to endure until the day that the Lord brings salvation unto the elect, man. And we pray to be of that number. Luke 18 and 8 here. "I tell you that he will avenge them speedily." Yeah, 1 hour Babylon's gonna be destroyed, man. It says, "Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth?" Yeah, he's only going to find the elect. Only them are going to be worthy to be redeemed from the earth. So when Son of Man cometh, when Yahweh Shai cometh, he's gonna avenge the elect, man. Him, Yahweh Shai, the chariots, all of them, man. The Lord's angels. They're gonna come and destroy this place and the wicked in 1 hour. And the elect are gonna be redeemed from the earth. This is why we pray, man, and we cry unto the Lord. We prophesy the downfall of this place, because the prophets are vexed, man. We know that Esau and wickedness is in rulership, man. And the scriptures say the whole earth mourn when the wicked are in control, man. Rough and paraphrasing. You know, Ecclesiastes 7:7, you know, surely oppression maketh a wise man mad. It says, and a gift destroyeth the heart. Better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. And the patient in spirit is better than the proud of spirit. So we have to be patient, man. We have to have faith in our salvation and faith that Yahweh Hashem Yahushai is gonna bring the kingdom, man, and set this upside world in the right place, man. You know, when the world of Jacob, you know, the age of Jacob return, man, it comes where we're unable to go off, man. You know, when this earth is going to be ruled in righteousness. So this line here is not our rest. That's why oppression maketh a wise man mad. So, you know, that's why the prophets and those that are in this truth are vexed, man. We see what they're doing to these, ruining the minds, man, of our people, our women, our children. You know, Esau is using all his wicked devices. He's preying on them, man. He's preying on the fatherless, those that don't have the spirit of truth, the widows, the orphan. But it says here, be not hasty in thy spirit to be angry, for anger resteth in the bosom of fools. Yeah, because we don't have no power right now to make things right yet. We have to be patient. And we know that vengeance is the Lord's. So we have to somehow find peace in knowing that if we continue to be diligent in our faith and our works, that Yahweh will redeem us. He'll have, you know, Yahweh Shai will redeem us. You know, when you're angry, it's when you make mistakes, man. You do things out of character, and then it's very foolish, man. You lie, you might just go off and break some of the laws, or you might do something stupid, man, that isn't what a man of the Lord would do. So say not thou, what is the cause that the former days were better than these? For thou dost not inquire wisely concerning this. So yeah, we can't say that it was better before or this or that, because we don't know what's gonna be the end part, you know. We know that better is the end, and better the end which we see is the kingdom, man, is going to be, you know, the age of Jacob, man, in rulership. Kingdom here. How about Shem Yahushua returning with the kingdom here on earth, man? That's going to be better than anything. That's going to be for eternity, man. It's going to be forever. That's going to be beautiful, man. It's going to be better than any of the former days, man. Any of your so-called glory days or, you know, your best memories that you cherish or this or that. Seeking the kingdom in those days, man. Being part of that elect. Just dwelling upon the among the Lord, man. The Lord and the Lord is said by King David, man. How shy. That's gonna be the best days that we have to look forward to, man. I'll bring that out here. Psalms 110 and 1 reads, Psalm of David, King David here. The Lord said unto my Lord. So Yahweh said unto Yahushua, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. So yeah, just like the apostles, you know, some of the apostles had seen Yahushua sitting at the right hand of the Father. You know, and that's until I make thine enemies thy footstool. So until he sends Yahushua to come destroy the wicked, man, he's prepared the kingdom for us, man. The elect, the hopeful elect right now. And then we pray to be of that number, but hey, the Lord said unto my Lord, Yahushua said unto Yah, or Yahweh said unto Yahushua, sit at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. So yeah, he isn't coming with peace, nay, but rather division. He's going to come back to punish the wicked for the elect's sake. So, Lord willing, this was edifying and a spiritual booster, you know. I pray that you brothers and sisters, you know, continue to hold firm, continue to seek to grow in this faith, in this ministry, continue doing the works, continue to stay in the spirit. Now I'd like to close this out by giving all praises unto Yahweh Bahashem, Yahushua Bahashem, Rakah Kodash. Double honors to the elders and head apostles of Great Millstone, who rule well and teach well, and have given us and taught us this truth. And Shalom to the hopeful elect. Keep pushing. Until the next time, Shalom.